Hello and welcome to another episode of Battlefield 2, Two Towers and Not Enough. In this surprising game, we put aside all of our differences and decide to play a game together. So here we have myself, goddammit, I forgot to do my goddamn name, Jimbo as Men. And down here, we have somebody. And up here, Gaz. And up here, we have Carl. So I take it that would be Jackson, but I guess one could imagine whatever that four-letter word. Let your imagination just fly. So over here, we thought we'd just do against four Brutals, and as we all know, on 108, the Brutals are really kind of brutal. So we thought that should be a pretty good game. So we got some Gobbos and some Elves. What was it? More Elves. Isengard, so yeah, not too bad. So yeah, we've got a Lurtsy boy coming over here. Alright, it's always good to get Boromir out. Everyone's massing to the front here. Yeah, random goblins just surrounding this, but... Oh, God. This elf is going down pretty quick from just a few of these bloody goblins. Bloody hell, I have to do heal on him for Christ's sake. Carl and Gaz double teaming all of these bastards. This is usually where they come in, like either through there or through here. So I'm right on the front lines. Level 5. Maybe that's why they're doing so much damage. These bastards are still going. Towers going up. And it's time to work in as well. I got some pikeys. I did the heal on it a bit too soon there. I hadn't even touched him yet. Alright. And I managed to get the Drake. Yeah, I'm gonna make short work of all of these troops, that's for sure. I'm pretty sure, Lurts and the other Lurts will have to deal with it. But there's some good team bonding on this side. Carl and Gaz, you know. Knowing me, knowing Carl. Here we go. Bloody bastards. Need to get those towers up, especially when there's elves afoot. Right. Now they have pushed all the way over here. Machines, they own the northern part of this map, so I would expect them to start sort of putting their farms and furnaces all across here. Maybe make a forward position here or something like that. But if they were to put a forward position there, this lot are not going to like that. They are not gonna like that one bit. Alright. He'll be holding the front at the moment, but there's not really much until this coming. Alright. And them as well, so I think at this point it does get a little bit hairy. And it looks like this blue force is sort of... Oh, he's got to be careful there, Gaz. Yeah. You've got to be careful. I think Carl's let you get sacrificed there. Carl thought, nah, I'm not going to lose my alerts over there. Thank you very much. Bad luck, Gaz. Right. Contact. Everything's kicking off now. I don't know where the hell my troops are. I think they're already all dead. Corner gondola. Just when you need it. Oh yeah.
I am afraid. What is it? Pull yourselves together.
Yeah, this is a lot of a lot of these buggers. But fortunately, these are just archers. These are the ones you have to take out first. No, just yet. He has got these two. This is really saving us right here. Killing the builder. No, not the builder. Alright, time to put the rangers in the tower. If they can get in there, of course. Did they make it? Yeah, they did make it. Some guys left made it. Holy shit. Alright. Looks like Carl came to the rescue here with some wargs and trampled over a lot of them, so that is good. Good play. Alright, now this Isengard unit on the warpath up here. Be careful. These wolves look a bit menacing. You're gonna lose alerts, Carl. Get him out of there. I'll bet Carl's probably thinking, oh shit, I didn't tell him to do that. That sucks. Two alerts and smoke. Well, the good thing is, I don't see any pikemen along here, so Carl could actually just go and run them over. So, there should be a good force here. This is good. Well played. Very nice. Oof. That ballista shot from Gaz there got a whole platoon of wolves. Ouch. Right. They seem to have stemmed the tide over here. It's going well. Random platoons. The computer seems to own this part of the map. We are having... there's quite a large force here. Jackson's got plenty. Yeah, always a good idea, Jackson. Good idea. Yep, tower up here. You never know, the computer might get a bit lippy. Thanks himself. Right. So far, so good. Good teamwork. Teamwork. Is Ed watching this? Right. Okay, making a heroic statue. Give everyone the bonuses. Butchered. Right. Rangers going in towers with heroic statues near them. That's exactly what you want. Gotta be careful there, Gaz. Butchered. Elrond. Pain in the ass. This is not what we need. We need that leadership over here, I think.
We should move!
Now, I probably should have told this tower to attack these guys instead of Elrond, because these guys are really doing a hell of a lot of damage. It's all kicking off. Another load of troops coming in this way. But Gaz and Karl seem to be teaming up nicely up on this side, making a bit of ground. I think it's probably a good idea because you guys are doing 2 versus 1 on this side, so it's sort of Karl and Gaz versus this blue Isengard. So if they can try and get a foothold over here, that'd be very advantageous. Last thing we need is the opposition having artillery and siege against our towers. We don't want that. All over the place, spewing out the pikies. All over the place. Right. Calm it, guys. Let's go down. Got to take these ballistas, we need the ballistas. It looks like the greens are helping the blues as well. Doesn't look good. Yeah, it's all kicking up here. An absolute slobber knocker. Good rebuild there, Jackson. Good rebuild. We needed these two towers to maintain the line. Could have been a problem if they went down. Alright, trying to make a line along here. But that thing is going down, please. Look how far that went. Right. Seems like a blurry, very blue map up here. Carl, Gaz, what is your next move? Because it looks like me and Jackson are doing it here. Actually, yeah, to be fair, yeah. Before you say anything, Gaz.
What about me?
Yeah, I know, you are doing it. Yeah, that's fair enough. Fair enough. So I guess we've got to ask, what the hell is Karl gonna do to be able to win this game? That's the question we gotta ask ourselves. So if the three of us are defending, what is Karl gonna do to try and win the game? Interesting. Zips in the wire. Might be a good idea to put some towers there, I think, Gaz. Finally. Always handy. Horn of the Gondor right next to a bunch of towers. Right, the blues are back on the warpath, but they're not going up this way. Interesting. Gaz is making a push. So we can reassemble some towers and get the line up. Glorfindel. Oh, he's gonna be toast. Toasted. Right. Yeah, probably didn't need that. But this does make a big opening here for Karl to get into there and try and make some sort of penetrating run. Yeah. Carl got him. Carl got him. He cripple strikes him and he wanted revenge. Carl wanted revenge for him getting his lurts. And he got it. Nice arrow volley. If I do say so myself. Alright. Look at like the opposition here. So like, right, 200 when they're meant to be 400. 150 when they're supposed to be 300. 175 when they're supposed to be 350. So basically you're looking at half price. 350, yeah. 250. Huh. I wish I could play a game when everything was half price. Look at this. That's not fair. 300. It's not fair. Alright. Nice formation there, Jackson. Very nice. Very nice. Right, we are getting the line up here. It is slowly going up. It is ready to go. Oops. Oh, let's go. Right. Okie dokie. Alright, what's going on here? It's going to be quite up here, but I've got all four of us are in the same position right here. Tell you what, Jackson, I don't know if it's worth it. Sometimes what I've done is I've had about like five catapults. You know, you maybe put them about here or something like that, and then you would tell them to target a certain area. So I think it probably works better if it's against brutals. I'm not sure if it would work against us, but it would certainly put us off. So if you had catapults that were always bombarding, let's say around this area right here, so the moment any troops come close, there's already a huge bombard like going on this area, so it's almost like they have to play potluck just to try and get through. So I've found that it's a good use of the catapults, because sometimes the catapults can shoot, but they shoot too far, and then it's sort of a waste. God, as if that thing can shoot from there. But we have got it sewn up. Gaz is involved. Jackson. I did have some rangers. I'm moving the rangers away, I think.
They're everywhere!
Everywhere! Right. What's Carl doing? Carl and Gaz. Attacking again. And he's got the upgrades. Ooh, that was a nice trample. Nice trample there, Carl. Because the pikies were... they had their backs turned. And they had their backs turned. But amazing... he almost did no damage on him. That's a bit unfair. Gotta get him out of there, mate. Gotta get him out of there. They're still level 1. They can't heal. Alright. Carl and Gaz, they're making a push now. Plenty of Mikeys. They're getting fed up. This should be good. Should be targeting these fuckers. Very nice, very nice. They're making a push up here, this is good. It's time to solidify this now. Arwen, smoke. Got him. Arwen and Haldir, dead. Upgraded as well with fire arrows. Very nice, Jackson. That just goes to show the and straight into Gaz's pikes. Very nice. I see the ballista and think to myself, just one ballista could basically make a huge shit show of everything here. And we don't want shit shows. What's going on here? I think you lads like should have brought some builders up with you or something like that. Ooh, wow, look at that. Oh, all those ballistas almost butchered that entire thing in one shot. Oh no, he's got bloody Saruman. This is the best way to do it. Especially if you can cripple strike Saruman and hit him with ballistas, it's the safest way to get him. Got him. He didn't move. Brilliant. I'm not quite sure why the hell he didn't move. I mean, these elven swordsmen belong to the opposition. But I-ho. Alright. Bring him up. Need reinforcements. Yeah, some builders, lads. I think a forward base or something like that with some towers along here. I think these are my horses. I'm just trying to do as much damage as I possibly can to as many ballistas as I can see on the map. Do I get it? Yeah! Alright. Farm here. Now, knuckling. Quite a few now. Big back and forth going on over here, this is for sure. I guess you're doing wargs, Carl, which is probably the best way to be in this map, because it is actually quite a large map, and you do need to have everything, but I think, like you guys have done before, even just something a little bit quieter, like up here or something like that, where you guys can have regular troops going in. Maybe some towers, like around here. Try and draw some of their fire and then eventually just wear them down. Right, Gimli out. That's always a good shout. Gaz on the front lines. Not letting these fuckers through. I think so far we've been playing pretty damn well, to be honest. I seem to have taken control of the northern bit. And Gaz and Jackson on the southern bit. Protect the build, the ballistas. I tell you, the spiderlings are really good against the siege. Yeesh. Yep, talk of the devil. Fuck. Alright. Just so you know, that rain and that trumpeting call from Isengard means you lose your leadership. Bloody mountain trolls. I mean mountain giants. That was Andy, it walked right into my end zone. Very nice. Need to get this fucker out. That's all I needed to do, just to kill him and then walk back. Alright. Yeah, nice. Nice little perch there, Jackson. I like that. Versus Gloin. Is there ever any doubt? I think this tower, look at the range on this tower. Yeah, Gloin didn't even break a sweat. Treebeard never seems to do anything. Every time I see the computer have Treebeard, he never seems to do anything. Alright. Looks like it's the Blue's turn to be able to own this map. I guess this must be like Jackson's, but I don't know, you guys have got to counter-attack and get this fucker. I'd go that way. We suspect it. Nice arrow volley. Oh yeah, here comes the cav. Nice run him over. No, not that way. Oh, very nice. Very nice cut. Oh, fucking nice, too. That was harsh. They got bogged down there, Carl. That was unlucky. But Lertz is pinging these guys off, which nullified their attack. Bring up some reinforcements there, I think. Alright, doesn't look like anyone's getting through here. Yeah, these Ents are bloody annoying. There we go. Gimli. Jackson taking care of things on the front lines, making sure there's no siege. Good work, good work. Dane as well. I never used Dane that much, but I don't know, the plus 25% damage, plus 25% armor. It is pretty handy straight from level 1, I must admit. But I thought Gimli, oh, plus 50% armor, okay. Gimli and Gloin and Dane. Yeah, well, yeah. That allows me to be able to build up all these towers pretty quick. Try and push down, make it very difficult for them to try and get anywhere near. Now, I'll bet these two ballistas, they are causing quite a few headaches. Ooh. Be careful. Ooh, I just missed. I think that might have just done it as well. That's almost nothing, man. That's nothing. Shit. Shit. Loads of ballistas. Gaz has his ballistas. Battle of the ballistas. Alright, that's one down. Guess you'd have to bring him up here, Gaz. It is interesting, when you do go for wargs, it is, can you destroy someone's base in this game? I'm not so convinced. Look out, they've got three of them. See you later. Yeah, that is toast. That is peanut butter on toast. Peasants. Ha! Do they do any damage? No, they look pretty bad. They're not doing any damage onto Gaz's troops. Probably not because Gimli's there giving them 50% armor, but... yep, those peasants got butchered. Butchered to a man. Right, Jackson's playing this very well, protecting all of these towers, and I'm able to push the towers further and further down. So that it basically becomes impossible for them to get anywhere close. Heroic statues everywhere, healing wells everywhere. Yep, toast. Nice, very nice. Alright. It looks like the blues have sort of failed right there. And now Gaz has got even more ballistas. And I always like to think that if the answer to all your problems is more siege. Two sides going in here, Elves, Isengard, but they just can't get through these towers, it's just too much for them. And we've got Jackson's catapults as well, even though that one's slightly smashing up against Carl's. Isengard, oh yeah. I think at this point we decided, didn't we, to save all of our power points until we can actually get a bit closer. So let's have a look. Me, I've got 1700, 320 out of 500. Gaz has got 1791 out of 500. Yeah, Jackson's doing alright. And Carl's doing alright as well. So, too bad we can't see what the computer has. Although it's probably something ridiculous. Even if we destroyed all of their trees or something like that, I'm sure they'll still have loads and loads of money. Thank you. quiet front this one now. Berserker doesn't even make it. Doesn't even make it. Can't even go close. Yeah, what's going on up here? Carl. Carl is happy trampling people with his wards. But he's got to be careful with these half-form wards. Eesh. God. Alright. Six ballistas. I like it. Very nice, very nice. But these ballistas need a bit of help. And help is on the way. Carl is there. But he's got to be careful not to get destroyed by his own ballista there. How's he going to take care of these things? Oh, holy shit! The AI did a zapper on Gaz's ballistas. Holy fuck beans. I have never seen that before. The computer actually took an educated decision and saw the danger and decided to get Gaz's ballistas. Well, yeah. Cool, maybe the AI in 108 is as close as you're gonna get to a human player. Have to take care of them. Bloody hell, there's a whole load of them. Whole load of them. This is my ultimate fear. And if ballistas start going up through here, this is a very difficult place to be in. Now, I believe I send hobbits up against these things. And surprisingly, the hobbits are actually really good. Bomb is going. No. And the hobbits, here we go. See, that's not doing too bad. Fair play. Yeah, they're doing awesome with that damage. There we go. Ha! That's so cool, he glows blue just because there's goblins near. That's so cool.
I have failed you.
You sure have, and you failed me, Frodo, by not taking out this one last ballista. Well, those hobbits were massacred. But it was worth it. Slightly less health, I think. 3,100. What's he got? 3,200, but I think he's got far more armor, Gloin has, than he has. 4,200. That does not surprise me. Right. This thing needs to go. Aragorn, to the rescue. Or is he? God, he's slowing the fuck down, isn't he? Taking your time.
Look out!
And is he gonna make it? I just gotta get out of there. Zeal on the fucker, but needed to kill this mountain giant. More of them. Right, here we go. Now, because the blues are fucking around down here, This has given Carl and Gaz perfect opportunity to get stuck in. Right. Time to get these bastards. Carl with the army of pikies and wargs, hoping to flatten everyone, but I don't like it against these after all marauders here, Carl. You'll have to be very careful. Oh yeah, full platoon, fully upgraded. Where are they going? Right. Big force going on over here. Jackson and I holding the line. I had a couple of platoons here, Gaz. I don't think you needed them here. Right. What is the best thing to do? What is the best thing to do here? Oh, those wargs got it bad. Bad. Right, I believe that was my cloud break. But, fuck me. I think that was three platoons of those wargs got murdered there, I think. That was very harsh. Alright. Lovely, good start, good start. Carl, we're hitting them with everything we got. Need to bring those Billy Ballistas up though, that's for sure. They need to assist before our invasion force gets completely wiped out. I think to myself, hey, Rohira might be a good idea. Yeah. Trample over a little bit. I start taking off all the buildings here. Bring him in, Gaz, bring him in, bring him in. This one's chilling. What's he doing? Trying to clump these fuckers as much as I possibly can. Get rid of these buildings. I'm not making too bad damage. Alright, here we go. A couple of buildings destroyed. There we go. Brought up enough time. Jackson got me involved. Is it time for the old Shatterhammer? Yes, it is. And that one move could basically cement the whole thing. And they decide to bring in the Ents to try and save themselves. They're doing everything they can, but the one thing I know about 108 is that they can still summon power points even when they don't have a fortress. Yep. You think I'm joking? I'm not joking. There we go. Just to make absolutely sure. I mean, that's the last thing you'd think if it was actually the enemy that had done that on you guys. Right. So we completely destroyed this force. Carl came back with more Vorgies. What's going on over here? A little bit of an attack. But this was devastating. As you know, Army of the Dead won't work really against buildings, but they will work goddamn well against buildings. Right. I try and send my Army of the Dead off as quickly as I possibly can. There's still quite a bit of time remaining there. We're going up after here, so... Dragon. Summoned. Oh no, not these things again. Will the Army of the Dead get there in time to save them? Oh, that just worked. Bloody hell, I think that just worked. The army of the dead just did enough damage. But they're coming back. I think they needed these guys in there with them. I think, Jackson, they needed help. Random Jones. Why am I dealt with this? Aragorn's just sitting right there. What the hell am I looking at? Yeah, they are building back. Alright, what's Gaz doing? Is Gaz going to have a shitload of ballistas again? Yes, he is. Carl, what is he doing? Might be careful there, Jackson, you might lose him. Maybe getting back there. Devastating. Carl does not
protect
need
these
that
lads. Guard this area.
I know Carl has nightmares about eagles now, thanks to me. Oh, mate, how the hell? You sent in the level 10 Gimli basically to fuck up their fortress. Very nice, Jackson. Very, very nice. There was nothing. And he got the builder. But it could be a sacrifice. He's not going to be able to get out of there. He sacrificed himself. I did try to heal him, but it wasn't enough. God. Look how much it takes to kill this fucker. Jesus. No, and like, they'll probably just have this builder just build a new fortress anyway.
Watch it.
Right. Oh, very nice. Very nice shot there, Jackson. Revenge for Gimli. I was about to say, there were a lot of troops clumped there, so if Army of the Dead, or Earthquake, or Shadowhammer, or something like that, that would have been quite tasty. You need protection. You can't just send in ballistas by themselves, they need help. Should have just hung back and waited for this force to arrive. Trying to move down the ramp here, making it impossible for them to get anywhere near. Yeah, they're busting through. They are not out of it yet, but now we're starting to close them in. This is a good idea, I think. It also means that you start drawing their attack, so that we don't get so much here between myself and Jackson, so we're actually free to actually make a push. Aragorn, taking care of business. So if these were pikers, Gaz, I think you would have been able to save these other ones, but the fact that they're making barracks up here with ballistas around, I think this is a good idea. Transition to pikers, I think, there, boys. Oh, this was daring, very daring, Carl, to try and get your wards all the way through with all of this shit. I don't know. I agree with you, Carl. I know you were mentioning about the transition to wards. I think perhaps in this instance, because you need to get through a very, very heavily fortified position, perhaps wards and speed might not necessarily be what you need here, because you haven't got big open spaces. Maybe wards for getting rid of these ballistas and things like that, that's a good idea. We need pikies coming out of here, pikies stat. Boromir's out, I'm slowly getting all the upgrades. I've been a bit short on money, I think. Yeah, very short on money. Just trying to make sure I stayed in the game. Yeah, Jesus. Jackson, cha-ching! They're just the bane of everyone's existence. Thank God we didn't have more than one Isengard team to go up against. Well, at least you guys have got the barracks up here. Wards. Let's see. Now, I think these wards here... Just narrowly missed that one. These wards, I think, are probably good at getting ballistas. And then probably going after, like... you know, farms and shit like that, I think. That's probably your best bet. And then maybe just clumping a few of these buildings, but as you can see here, look how much stuff they have. You're gonna have to slowly get through here, and I think this is probably the most heavily fortified position on the map. So... Jackson's made a mine. This is helpful. He can bring his boys in. Carl, I think a couple of your barracks or something like that behind would have been pretty helpful too, man. Alright, Jackson's getting involved. I'm pretty much just, hey, you know what? I'll take care of this. I'll make sure they don't get past us, and I'll defend. Eric going here. Boromir here. We should have got these ones. Alright. We need to make a big push in here. Last thing you need right now is perhaps one of these enemy teams, like the goblin team, to like send in a Balrog or some shit. He's filled with arrows, but he's making his way in. Ooh. Devastating. I think heroes or pikies. Oh, that is fucking crippling, that is. I think I do an arrow volley here, I think. Yoink. Is there anything that hero can't do? Great, dead. This is a real fight to the death here. Some archers would have been helpful. Whew. Yeah, this is a difficult fight, but it's the fight we need to have. There we go. Bam. You're welcome, lads. Now I'm making the pass. I suppose no men of Dale or something like that. Even a few crossbowmen would be alright. I need to bring them in, need to bring these bad boys in to trample the rest of them. Gaz has got the right idea. I need to be careful of this fucker though. This was a one hell of a bloody battle right here. This needed to be won. Oh, this eagle. He's got to be very careful. Very, very careful. I hear something bad. Actually, that was a very wise decision to get that card, because this thing is a lot weaker than 108, so it doesn't actually get anything else. Right, I summon the rangers to try and deal with this bloody eagle. Carl bringing up the wards. Pikey, Gaz has transitioned well. Maybe a hearth or something like that, I think would have been pretty good, or a healing well, I think, for the others. Oh, they're making it. Ooh. Bloody hell, just when he was about to get through. Oof. Oh, they've all got to push in. Still bloody attacking on this side. Jesus. They've gone quiet a little bit, but the greens are still dangerous. Painful. Just this little bit here trying to get through is a bloody nightmare. Yeah, it's interesting location for a tower. Interesting. I guess here is good, but trying to make it, perhaps making towers here is perhaps a little bit too hot at the moment. A bit difficult. Gimli versus a worm? Is he enslaved? He's got to be very careful, Jesus Christ. Get him out of there, Jackson. I wonder what Shatterhammer would do on that. Fuck it, I'm not letting them get close. Push them out. So he just sits there. I don't know what the fuck his deal is. What's your problem, huh? Asshole. Right, even I'm starting to make towers there just to make sure, just so we have this position here that they cannot get past. They are just spewing out troops, spewing them out. Greens coming down here. Some of them are attacking, some of them are just, not really doing anything. This is creepy weirdo. Right, now we've got a lot of pikeys coming in. I think some, yeah, a lot of pikeys with crossbowmen. I think that's a good combination here. Yeah. It is a difficult one to be able to have, the location. Where's that landed? Where's that landed?
This way, Lancers.
I thought I heard a... Am I mental, or did I just hear a... In the center of the map or something. Huh. Okay, must be hearing things, I guess. Oh, this is some good teamwork. Oh. I see. This is the Brutal's Dragon, and you guys... Oh no, oh no. Oh god. How are they still alive? He needs to move in, doesn't he? Maybe not this time. He's gonna fuck all his own troops up as well, right? Huh. Is there some sort of glitch that I'm like looking at here? Because I thought these things were meant to be all mental or something like that in this version. Nice one, Gaz. My dragon's better than your dragon. Wow, did no damage. There's something wrong with this one. You'll just have to wait until Gaz has cleared all of this with the dragon, I think. Yep, nicely played. Fuck everything up. There we go. Busting a hole in there. This could be the breakthrough. Bring these boys up. Ballistas, if you got them. Yeah, this is more like it, lads. Bring them in. Well, don't you worry. This is a very safe space right here. Everyone's safe over here by these towers. I'll just let you guys deal with it. Oh, they tried to zap her. I tried to zap at your dragon. That's so cool. Now, Carl is wisely enough steering clear. I believe this is Carl's. Carl's and Gaz's dragon. Very nice. And a meteor shower. And I believe I did earthquake as well. Hitting her with everything we got. Nice. Very nice. And the forward mine there. Surely this should be all she wrote. Be careful here, because you don't want to get them all burnt to a crisp by this dragon. Oh yeah, that's doing damage on these guys. Yeah, be careful, lads. Holy shit. Gonna lose the damn heroes because of the dragon. It did heal, it did heal. We spotted the danger. Right. Carl, Gaz, moving in. Moving in. God, yeah, they're fucking this up more than the enemy is. Right. I'm making some horses. This lot have to be toast. The double dragon. Carl and Gaz, Double Dragon. That was harsh. I thought that would have been enough to destroy that. Where's Lurtz to give him plus 50%? Dragon destroyed the fortress. Gimli and Thane destroying the seed birds. Very nice. Oh, that's a nice plumpty dumpty action that is. Beautiful, beautiful. Oh, be careful there. Oh, he's getting there. Well, I tell you what, that was convenient that he didn't get too close. Only one Uruk got burnt with crisp. Right, these guys and then the greens. And that's going to be all she wrote. Alright, good forward base here. No one's going through this thing, that's for sure. Nice little pause and freeze there. And these greens are still going. Jesus. Then we needed to have repositioned this catapult, I think, Jackson. There's just nothing they can do. Nothing they can do. Boromir defeats Shelob. My Rohirrim, my little contribution to an assault. But it looks like a lot of the big work is going about to be done here. Alright. Gaz has his forces over here, very nice. Pell's bringing them on this side. More seeds. May a few ballistas? Yeah, a few ballistas would be pretty nice. Oh no, now the greens have found you. Yeah, it's a good thing you had a couple of troops and alert station there. Earthquake. Nice. Good start. Am I right here? Where the hell are they? I suppose I haven't tainted the terrain actually. That would have been a lot more helpful. And yes, I guess I did. Right. Right, absolute mess time. Everyone has some sort of objective to destroy as much as you possibly can. Right, destroy that. There we go. Building by building. Cripple their ability to reproduce any sort of troops. Nice citadel action by Jackson. Really putting them to the sword. Clunking this. Very nice, very nice. Still see some greens there. No. I have. That is what you call royally bummed. Oh no, they've got a bloody worm. Have to destroy him. Have to destroy him before this thing sets light to everything. Yeesh. Yeah, that's right. Run away, run away. Get this thing, get this thing. Need to get this as well. Guns are still attacking, but it's a lot less than what it once was. We've always got, Gaz, what is this? This is like three or four platoons here. Army of the Dead. I love it. their response. Some water horses. I thought it might be a good idea to try and destroy all of their troops. Pikes. I'm not sure if you needed the shatter hammer there, Jackson. I think that my guys were going around just murdering them anyway. Is it Clumpty Dumpty time? Clumpty Dumpty time. Why not? Why not? And this is a time where everyone just sort of puts in every PowerPoint you possibly can. Hobbits, hey, just get them involved. Wow, the hobbits are actually doing good damage against this green pasture. Great. Bloody hell, look at all the bonuses these guys have got. Nice little cloud break for myself. Jesus Christ. It's a good thing there's no shatter hammer right here. Jesus. And wildmen. Wildmen just to make sure. Yay! Well done, lads. I like the name of this game that I saved it as, which was the Avengers Assemble. But yes, excellent one, lads, and I'll catch you on the next one.